presence is headed to your home state for a campaign-style rally next week. I want to get your take on this because Phoenix Mayor Greg Stanton is urging the president to change the plans, postpone the rally. Here's what he says. I am disappointed that President Trump has chosen to hold a campaign rally as our nation is still healing from the tragic events in Charlottesville. It is my hope that more sound judgment prevails and that he delays his visit. Congressman, should the president postpone the rally in your home state?
No, I think he should go ahead and come. I think it's important to get out and speak to the people. If you want to, if the president's going to unite this country, he needs to get out and speak to people. And Mayor Stanton's positioning himself for a post-mayoral race somewhere, so I get what he's saying, but I think that's more political than the reality.
Congressman, it's been said that from sources on Capitol Hill that many of the people in Congress are losing faith in the president. They believe that they shouldn't go on a limb and support part of the agenda because he won't give them cover. Are you getting that feel on Capitol Hill?
I'm not hearing that too much. I've heard a couple people say that, but the reality is most of the people in the Republican conference in the House anyway are right there with the Republican agenda. We know that's the promises we've made. I talked to leadership, actually, a member of leadership just a couple days ago, saying I'm going to be on with Maria. I said, what do you want me to say? I mean, are we still there? Are we still working on health care? Are we still doing this? And he said, yeah, the Republican agenda is still our objective. We're still going forward. And we're going to do the best we can to get that objective done.
Yeah, because yesterday there was all sorts of rumors after all the CEOs were, responding to the president's commentary on Charlottesville. And there was some rumors that Gary Cohn is under fire. There's pressure for him to leave. Who knows with Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin. Are you worried that the president's going to lose cabinet members?
Yeah, I don't think he's even had all his cabinet members confirmed yet. So, yeah, I think that this has been a very difficult transition period. I think there's some let's just face it, you could point fingers at a lot of people, but I think I am concerned because we want that stability in the White House. I don't think there are certain groups within the media that are never going to approve of anything he does, and they're going to just fight him all the way. There are people within the House that are going to fight him and try to be obstructionist, and in the Senate all the way. I am concerned.
You're concerned that cabinet members could step down?
They might. I mean, there may be some pressure. I'm not privy to what goes on internally, of course, but I mean, we want stability in the White House. We want stability in the House and Senate. That's important for the country.
Course.
It's important for the economy.
Congressman, you know, the president is tweeting about all sorts of stuff this morning. That's one of the issues, right? I mean, people want to know that he's focused on the agenda. Here's his tweet this morning. I got to get your reaction to this. He says, great to see that Dr. Kelly Ward is running against Jeff Flake, who is weak on borders, crime, and a non-factor in the Senate. He's toxic. What do you make of the president's criticism here of Jeff Flake?
Well, the reality is those two kind of have this running war of words, I guess. Jeff came out with a book, I guess, a week or so ago, and is pretty critical of the president, has been critical of the president, and this is the way this president operates. I mean, he's going to say what's on his mind.
He's going to say what's on his mind, but you just wonder if it's going to be an issue for the country's progress, right? You seem to have legitimate worries, Congressman.
Well, you have to understand, I am an eternal optimist.
Okay.
And so
are we.
So I see some obstacles, but those will make us stronger, and I think we can overcome those. And as we do so, I think we're going to get this agenda done. I mean, we have to work like crazy. I was disappointed we didn't stay in session in August. I was one of the ones pushing for that. But we've got to go forward.
Right.
We've got to get this agenda done.
All right, Congressman, thanks very much for your candor this morning. We'll be watching
Thank you.
The developments. Congressman Andy Biggs there. Stay